Hello friends, welcome to this platform. See, time is a wonderful thing. If you keep check of time, you will be a successful person, and if you let the time pass away, the time is going to destroy you. No one will understand this particular fact better than the one who is aspiring to become a civil servant. A civil servant has to be quite vigilant about the time. I'll leave this time and discussion topic as of now, but what I wanted to convey to you, the smart people have already got it, and those who haven't got it, they will soon get it at the end of the video. Basically, we at Raj Malhotra IAS have brought to you a test series well in advance to make you comfortable before the Prelims 2020, which will be held on 31st May 2020. This test series is almost 270 days in advance than the day you will be entering the examination hall to write the paper. This time frame of 270 days though look a very big, but it actually isn't. This isn't enough for the person who want to crack this exam, and this is a way too much time for the person who is not at all serious. So choose the category you belong to. I am not here to make you choose that category, you yourself has to choose. What I am over here is to explain to you the structure of the test series and the importance of this test series. Let's begin. If we talk about the test series structure, this test series is structured in a very wonderful manner that we are going to cover first the sole topics of each and every subject. In polity, there are n number of different topics, and these n number of different topics can be broken down into n different segments, and then we can club all the segments together and ask you comprehensive questions. Apart from that, there is not just GS component, there is also a CSET component. So if I talk about the structure, we have structured this test series in such a manner that there will be 26 subject wise tests. Every subject, it will be in a form of brokered manner. There will be some component of polity in one test, the remaining component in second test. There will be some component of economy in one test and some remaining topic of economics in some other test. So this is how the subject wise tests have been done. We'll be asking you the nuances and those topics which we are most likely to be asked in the examination. Then there are six comprehensive tests to make you feel as if you are writing the paper. After giving this 26 plus 6, that is 32 tests, I don't think so that you will be feeling any way underconfident before entering into the examination hall. Apart from that, three tests, CSET test, the civil services aptitude test, three aptitude tests are more than sufficient to assess whether you have an aptitude for the civil services or not. I am sure that if you give these 35 tests in true spirit, you will be one among the few confident people who will be entering the examination hall on 31st May 2020 with full confidence, and that confidence is enough to play the wonders. Going ahead, let us look at what all we'll cover. See, I am not over here to make very broad based claims, but I assure you that very few test series in India can afford you the coverage that we are offering. For example, some tests will be covering NCRTs. After NCRT, we'll be talking about the standard books. Along with the standard books, current affairs from January 2019 onwards till mid of May 2019. Such a broad coverage of current affairs is very necessary, because gone are the days when you required just 1 year's current affairs. Today you require multiple current affairs of at least 1.5 years. So January 2019 is the apt time to begin with the current affairs until the day you enter into the examination, or at being on the safer side, I can say till 15th May 2019. These current affairs will be provided in the test series gradually. Then we'll be also asking questions in the test series from you on budget, very important document. The budget which was presented by the government in this July 2019, we'll be asking questions from economic survey, and we'll also cover the India yearbook. I think that after covering all these dimensions, I don't think so there is anything left that is to be studied or tested before going into the actual examination. All right, now what I personally believe, and almost every successful individual personally believe, that gradual is always good. What do you mean by gradual? If I throw you the toughest question at the first instance, you will be underconfident, you will feel that your preparation is not on the right tracks, and whatever be that, it is going to make you uncomfortable. However, if we go building it gradually, this increases your confidence, and this confidence is what we try to provide to you. We can ask you fancy questions and make you feel underconfident. At the same time, we can ask you realistic questions which come in UPSC and make you feel confident. That's what we believe here at Raj IAS. Now, if we talk about the gradual component in the test series, we will increase the toughness of the test in three-tier structure. There will be level 1 tests. These level 1 tests will be test of your NCRT based knowledge. We will test your NCRT based knowledge and see these are the tests which are starting tests. You will be doing really good in this. That confidence will help you perform better in the level 2 test. The level 2 test is testing your knowledge which you acquired from the standard books. NCRT is level 1, standard books are level 2. However, a sincere civil services aspirant, he just does not limit himself to NCRTs or standard books. He also tests reference books. So the level 3 will be the toughest level examination, toughest level questions in the test, and this will test your standard books, NCRTs along with reference book from each subject. If you carry yourself from level 1 to level 2 and level 2 to level 3, I don't think so that any question in UPSC prelim examination on 31st May 2020 is going to bug you or trouble you. Alright, apart from that, current affairs will be asked in the similar gradual toughness level. Level 1, current affairs in the level 1 test, level 2 current affairs in the level 2 test, level 3 current affairs in the level 3. In the comprehensive test, the 6 comprehensive test, there will be the mix of the questions of different level, such that if you are a sincere candidate, you yourself can test the reality. Alright, this is what is known as the realistic test series planning, and it is a realistic test series planning. Apart from that, now the question will come to your mind, am I ready to pursue this test series? Well, if you are a sincere civil services aspirant, you are ready to give the test right from the day you decided to crack this exam. Why? Because gone are the days of learning and testing. Today you don't have to learn and test your knowledge. Today you have to increase the quotient of your knowledge in such a manner that you learn and test. Along with this, you also test and learn. How to do that? How to test and learn? This is the next question that must be coming to your mind. Let me clear that doubt also. Now, if you attempt any question, there are only two possibilities. Either you know or you don't know. If you know, it will be a correct answer. If you don't know, you mark it, it will be a wrong. Or if you leave it, it is still a wrong answer. So there are two possibilities, correct and wrong. If there is a correct answer, you will be feeling good. But do not just leave that at this point. After feeling good, try to find out the reason or explanation of the entire answer. It is many a times possible that you may know some facet of the topic and other facets might not. That will be cleared when you read the explanation. Alright, read the explanation of the correct answer, as there may be some time that the explanation contains something which you do not know or you did not think about. Getting my point? So reading the explanation is one of the very important thing that is required out of a sincere civil services candidate. Apart from that, what is required is that if you get an answer wrong, in the wrong answer, what you have to do is you have to find out your mistake. Identify the mistake, where you made the mistake. Correct it. Read the explanation. Read the entire topic given in the explanation. Aur jo cheez aapne galat kari, usko sahi karo. It is a personal experience and experience of my fellow successful candidates who have said this thing that wrong answers helped him understand the topic more than the correct answers. Because when they got an answer wrong, they basically identified their mistake, they corrected their mistake. And trust me, if you practice this exercise, never ever in your life you will forget the answer to this question. Kyunki aapne galti kari aur galti sudhar ke galti ko yaad rakhna aur sahi cheez pe pahunchna, that is what is called achievement. So I encourage you to do mistakes in this test. Correctify your mistakes so that you will not be doing these mistakes on the judgment day, that is 31st May 2020. All right. Now this funny man, he always comes and says, ab chain se sona ho to jaag jao. I am just changing it a little bit and I am saying that agar ab chain se paper dena hai to jaag jao, kyunki 274 days to prelims is not a big time. It is not a big time, and I am not joking around ki 274 days will pass like this. You will not realize when it is just a month. Time flies like anything, and time always credit and time always reward the people who are early birds. Apart from that, this is the right time to do mistakes. Do mistakes here with us, but do not do that mistakes on 31st May 2020. You will lose your one complete year and a precious attempt. Giving the test, experience the stress and the examination like environment, so that you will not be feeling terrified or you will not be feeling uneasy or anxious on the day you are writing the paper. Do these things here, because these things will not kill you, and what doesn't kill you makes you stronger. Mind my words, this is true. All right. Now I would conclude by just three words. Yes, we can. Yes, we can, Barack Obama. These three powerful words. It's not you who are writing the paper, it's we along with you people. If you trust in us, we trust in you. Combined together, we can crack any hardship that we can face. And this is just a prelim examination. So call on the numbers given in the description and the tagline below. Inquire for the test series, enroll as early as possible so that we can assure a good result for you. All the best. Do not think you have completed the course, pura nahi hua hai, aadha adhura hua hai. It is immaterial. The thing is this, after testing you will also learn. So I encourage you, go ahead, come to us, talk to us, enroll and fight this examination with us for the wonderful results. That's all from my side. Have a great day ahead. Take care. Bye.